Shalom, Ras Tafari. Ine Ras Iadonis Tafari Ning of the line of Jewish Society of Imperial Majesty, Wendim Yadon, reporting on this Ethiopia World Net presently on the YouTube, but you can join us on the Facebook and check us out at www.lojsociety.org. Now, this is kind of a follow up to something else that we just uploaded, and you can check this out right here. If we go to this window right here, right, you can see where it says notes. Okay, good. Notes, right? See what it says, notes. This is a document, actually. Let's make this this recording right here the document. I don't know if any one of us have it. We had a copy of this. Got it from, I think, Dr. Richard Green. He had a copy. This is years ago, right? We give thanks, and may God bless him and his family. That this document here, Notes on the Golden Sceptre, has been presented, this particular researching Sceptre and Budge and Selassie, in order to find it. There's also this very good page right here, Black Briton, the seeds that created. Right? Seeds that created. And so now the scepter was returned by the Duke of Gloucester, right? And it gives a description, some of the description of this particular scepter. And there's also corresponding pages out there. Some of them are no longer online, like there's some 12 Tribe of Israel information that was on one of Bill Gates' site, you know, that whole Microsoft MS, and a lot of those sites are no longer there, like a lot of the AOL sites are no longer there either. So you still see the link, but you can't find it. So what we published about 4 hours ago right here is the Jamaican Rastafari belt, or, you know, the red, gold, green belt, Haile Selassie and the Order of the Garter. We're explaining a little bit more on that and the connection, right? And then in the description, we have this particular document right here. Now, what we're requesting is that if any of you all have it, any of you brethren or sisterin, if you can either make a copy of it, you know what I'm saying, or scan it, put it up there, PDF it, you know, if you need any, if you want to reason about how best, or if you're not too savvy, then just link with one of I and I, or even on the Ethiopian World Net, on the Facebook, you can put it up there as well. This document right here, let's click on this link. Let's see, let's click on this link right here so you can see this better. We're going to the Google, right, the Google book, and here it goes right here, this particular document right here, the Notes on the Gold Sceptre, which has been presented by His Majesty King George V, or King George V, to His Majesty Haile Selassie, King of Kings of Ethiopia, and the Gold and Ivory Sceptre, which has been presented by Her Majesty Queen Mary to Her Majesty Wayzarô, right, Wayzarô. Now, this is only an 8-page document. This is by Sir Ernest, Alfred, Wallis, Budge. This is by Wallis Budge, right? But there's no link here for it. If you notice down here, it's only 8 pages, right? It's only 8 pages. It was published in 1930. And so they're suppressing this particular document, but there are photocopies of it. I know, because we had photocopies, but somehow some of the pages were removed, so we only have a very small portion of that. But it's only 8 pages, so we're asking, you know, I and I, Rastafari brothers and sisters, maybe Brother Seymour McLean, or Seymour might have that. Yovs, and he's a Arbenya, he's a patriot, so he might have that. There might be others out there that have this particular document. So if you can, please, we need to get this document in circulation, because it's suppressing this document. Because we're speaking about the black, so-called, the black British, right, or Black Briton, right? Now, when you click on this link here, Black Briton, the seeds that created, and right now they might try to change up these links. So get on it when you check this out, right? Get on it, download the information, back it up, put it on a floppy or put it on a thumb drive or something like that, right? But here is the scepter. The keywords are scepter, budge, and Selassie, right? Scepter, budge, and Selassie, the 1L spelling, right? And now when you click on this link right here, it's a very, very good page that essays by Ikoa, right? Essay by Ikoa, Black Briton, the seeds that created Europe. The seeds that created Europe. This is the British Isles, the Yovas. And they suppress the fact of the black blood that goes way back in England. There's a whole link about Glastonbury. You might have heard about Glastonbury. We have a very good document on Glastonbury, how Joseph Arimathea, how he went, you know, the one who, with the body of Jesus, Yosef and Yeshua, he's the one that went to Pontius Pilate, and how he went to this place called Glastonbury, traveled by ships. And man, the British people, there's a lot of British Israelites, but they've been affected by that bug of racism, kind of like the Mitt Romney kind of doctrine and everything like that. So they deny the black presence, even though, well, her article here goes into a lot of the details right here that really helps to link it a little bit more thoroughly. So we say to you, check this page out, make a copy of it, save it, print it out, right? This is the Black Knight right here. The Black Knight, and she gives a lot of references and sources too. You understand? So she's not just speaking out right here, but reference, even the connection with the Ashan. When we talk about Bobo Ashanti, right? Ashan is also the word used for Jerusalem and its environs. Because man, the Ebo and the Yoruba people, said they came out of Jerusalem, but they were running from global white supremacy, you understand, and therefore that's why they went into Africa. You understand? They went deep into Africa. They crossed the rivers from beyond the rivers of Ethiopia. They crossed the Nile. They crossed the rivers and went into West Africa. So the Ashan people, like the Ashanti or the Ashan people, Ashan is the word that's used for Jerusalem or Jerusalem and its environs after destruction and dispersion in 70 A.D., right? The Ashan tribe, you understand, the Ashan tribe, or Ashanti of Ghana. Mm-hmm. The Ashanti of Ghana. So when we see our Bobo Ashanti brethren and sisterin in the communities making that link with Ghana, well, it is only right, it's only proper. They derived their name from this even since they were part of the tribe of the Hebrews that ran for their very lives, right, from blatant white supremacy, from the destruction, and relocated in what is now Ghana, Africa. So even a lot of these customs, like the umbrella, and, you know, there's a whole bunch of customs and everything that, if you know the Bible, right, you'll recognize exactly what this is all about. So we have here an Ashanti prince, right, Ashanti prince, and then we have the word Ta and T, and we go back to ancient Egypt, and we see a link, you know, right there with the Ta, because the Ta was the Tau. The Tau in Hebrew is like a circle with an X in it, and it's known as a mark. It says in let's just connect the T and the Ta right there for a moment. Now we become like the builders, because we're still on that point, rebuking that point about the so-called Masons and Freemasons and Haile Selassie and the confusion around that. Let's just put here mark right here, right? A mark, right? And so we can show you what the Ta and the T, and those of you who know, hieroglyphics, if you've been studying the hieroglyphics in the ancient Medunet, would already recognize this. So when we go to, let's go to the prophet, right? Right here. It says right here, if you notice, in 9 and 4, and many of the Hebrew, black Hebrews alike, they point to this. In 9 and 4, it says right here, and the Lord Yahweh said to him, go through the midst of the city, through the midst of Jerusalem, and set a mark, right, upon the foreheads of the men that sigh and that cry for all the abominations that be done in the midst thereof. And it was set a mark on them. It's not the mark of the beast. Don't get it twisted now. Set a mark, a cross. Like in Ethiopia, we have the tattoo with the cross. There's that mark. All right? So the mark on them. Now it says here in verse 6, it says, slay utterly old and young, both maids and little children and the woman, but come not near any man. Don't come near any man upon whom is the mark. Now this mark is the cross. Let's understand this. This mark is that X. And we're speaking spiritually here, right? And begin at my sanctuary where they began at the ancient men which were before the house. Now if you notice here, mark here in the Strong Concordance is 8420. There's a different mark here. That's 7760. So you have to understand that when you're studying. That's why the Bible says study and show yourself approved. A lot of fools just look at the translation, you know, and don't recognize that the word is Christ, and they think all the translations are the same, and so they make wrong interpretations or misinterpretations because they're novices. They're novices, all right? And they fall under the condemnation of the devil because they go out there saying things and deceiving people. Even up here, there's a different word for mark up here. You understand? So it's all not the same mark. But in the English, right, in the English, if you're lost in translation, then it appears the same. See, here's why studying our roots, some say why we study the roots, why studying our roots is very important. Now, you see what's right here? It's a Hebrew word, according to the modern Ashkenazi. If you're Ashkenazi, they say it's Tav. It's the H, the Strong's H, Hebrew, 8420. Tav. It's actually Tau. It's actually not Tav, but it's Tau. Like Tau, Tawe. Tau, which means cross. You understand? Which means cross, right? Or we can say the T. They say the T marks the spot. Now, what does it say down here? It says the meaning of it is a desire or mark. Mark as a sign of exemption. See, the cross is a mark of a sign of what? Exemption. You see it right here. The cross is the mark as a sign of exemption from what? Judgment. Because they have Christ. They have been crucified with Christ. You know what I'm saying? So they have that stability in their mind. Now notice what it says down here. It says Tav or Tau from Tawa, right? Tawa or Tawe. Right? From the root Tawa, right? It says a sign. It's a sign according to Ezekiel 9 and 4. Right? Now here's the Arabic, right? Here's the Arabic language. It says a sign in the form of a cross. You see that? It's a sign in the form of a cross. Like we see Lalibela or Lalibela, we see that cross. It's branded on the thigh or the neck of horses and camels. Right? It says, whence the name of the letter Tau, right? The letter Tau, which in Phoenician and on the coins of the what? The Maccabees. So we have a Maccabee connection here. Let's understand it. We have a Maccabee connection. So Rastafari, we're the only ones who really are speaking about the book of Maccabees. Understand that. Maccabees, right? Then a Maccabee means a hammer, right? A hammer. That's what a Macca, a Medosha, it's a hammer, right? Has the form of a cross, right? From the Phoenicians, it says, according to Strong's, the Greeks and the Romans took both the name and the form of the letter. So who took it? The Greeks and the Romans, Europeans, white people. You understand? This is where Europe rises, when black supremacy fell. You understand with 70 AD and Jerusalem. Now look at the secondary meaning right here. It says right here, a sign, a cruciform, a mark that's subscribed instead of a name to a bill of complaint, of a betuta, that mark, that X. Hence, it's a subscription. according to Job 31:35, like what happened to the enslaved Israelites, the Hebrews in America. You know what I'm saying? Well, they didn't want to teach one to read or whatnot or to write, so they said just mark an X right here. It is stated that at the synod of Chalcedon, or Chalcedon, remember the connection of Chalcedon with Ethiopia, and other synods or synods, principally in the east, right, or the orient, look to the orient, don't be disorientated looking to the west, some of the bishops being unable to write, some of the bishops were unable to write, but they were holy men. You understand? And I'm saying this seriously. You understand? We have to understand that they wasn't able to write, but many of them memorized the Bible and they lived it. You understand? So they put the sign of the cross instead of their names. And it's interesting that they did that. Maybe they were able to write, but it goes back to Ezekiel, you understand, 9 and 6. Because remember the council of Chalcedon or Chalcedon, that the Ethiopians have a different interpretation of that. You over what I'm saying? So some of even the bishops being unable to write, they put the sign of the cross instead of their names, which is still often done by common people in legal proceedings, right? So that in the infancy of the art of writing, this could not fail of being the case, so as for the expression to be received in the usage of language, in the usage of language. Now, that's not all, my people, but let me just go right here so we know it's top, right? Let's just look up something right here. Let's look up Hebrew, right? And let's look up Tav, and let's look up cross, and see what comes up. Let's just kind of like look at the pictures for a moment, right? Let's go to the images right here, right? The images, right? So we can see what these images, right? What these images are. Okay, we see that right there. This is Babylonian, right? That's the Babylonian right there. Now, you can see that right there, right? The modern Tav. And notice where the Tav is. Notice where it is. You understand? That's basically the hand sign of peace. You know what I'm saying? That's the Tiferet. That's known as Tiferet. Right? Tiferet. And Tiferet is Tafari. Tafari or Tafara. So let's understand that. In fact, let's click on this right here. Right? Let's click on this right here. We want to get this picture right here and just kind of back it up. You know what I'm saying? We want to back this up, all right? Because sometimes you come across it, and then you look for it later on, and you can't find it, and you think like, say, you know, you think like, say, you're going crazy or something like that. You're not really going crazy. They just remove that. You understand? And this often, you know what I'm saying? This actually often, this often happens. So let's see if we can bring this up right here again. So, now, understand, we're on the Tav. Even though we were speaking about the scepter and so forth and so on, we are on the Tav right here, right? And we're showing that this is the cross is a mark. And we showed you in Ezekiel how this is a mark of exemption. You know what I'm saying? A mark of exemption. Now, when we look to the east, when we look to the orient, you know what I'm saying? When we look to the proper, understanding of this particular. Notice where it's at. You see what I'm saying? Let's understand. You know, let's understand where it's at. We're just backing this up right here, brothers and sisters. You understand? Because sometimes we try to find these things later on. You understand? And you know, we can't find them. You understand? There's pages that we saw recently, and we've had to actually go into the archives. You understand? And so we got to share information. Share this intelligence, all right? So that right there, the Tiferet right there, now this is Babylonian. This is the Babylonian, right? This is, all right, this is the Babylonian, get that right there. So this is the Babylonian square Hebrew. They don't want it to come up, but you know, we're talking about them, right? So it doesn't want to zoom in. This one will zoom in, right? The ox, the strength of Yahuwah, or Yahweh, is in the sign of the cross. You over that right there, the strength of Yahweh is in the sign of the cross. So you can see the ox, right? The ox. This is
This is old Hebrew, right? This is old Hebrew right here, right? This is old Hebrew, right? This is Babylonian Hebrew. After the Babylonian exile, this is an A and this is a T, right? This is an A and this is a T, all right? At, right? But then the way they read it as an X, ox, you know what I'm saying? They read it as an ox, but it's really a T. So you can see that cross right there. Like Lalabella cross, all right? So, yeah, save that right there, Miss Ghana. Give thanks. So we're just saving this right here because, like we said, sometimes if you don't save these things, later on you look for them and you can't find them. You know what I'm saying? You can't find them. So, basically, you know, there's more on this that you can look at for yourself here. There's also a Alpha, Omega, or Aleph Tav. You understand? We got Aleph Tav right there. Right? Tau is the cross. So are we pretty persuaded on that? You understand? Because here's the information about it. We're showing you this information. There's a whole bunch of... Now, here's what we was looking for, actually. We was actually looking for this right here. All right? We was looking for something like this to show you. When you look in ancient Metunet or ancient Egypt... Right, there's a sign like this, but they turn it on the side where it's more like an X, right? And that X right there is a land marker. Yeah, Miss Ghana, yeah, it's a land. You see how that's a land marker? That's a land marker in ancient Egypt. It's a land marker. You understand? And you can see that like Kemet, Kam-ta, really Kam-ta, or Kam-tau, Kam-ta, right? But they say Kemet because that's the way they have taught you. You understand, and you believe that, and you haven't done your own study for yourself. Make it a little bit smaller, because when we come forward to it, it's probably going to be a little bit, okay, that's good. Yeah, that's, so we can see this as large, you know, as large and as clear as possible for this presentation. Now, if we put Egypt there, we might see it a little bit better. Okay, well, there's a whole bunch of stuff right here. They have a little bit of Egyptian stuff down here, pseudo-Egyptian, modern Eurocentric Egyptian, right? So we can see that very clearly. And then you can see how these shapes, you understand? And people say, oh, that right there is the Nazis. You see, because these people are disorientated, right? They're disorientated. So everything they see, they're going to give credit to someone else because they are not able to interpret it. So therefore, these symbols don't work for them. These symbols can be used to work against them, right? These symbols can be used to work against them. And here in the, here on the Kabbalah tree, you can see what we are speaking about right here, Tiferes. So you can see this a little more clearly, right?
Remember, the Pharisees had their Kabbalah, and Yeshua, our Black Lord and Savior, had his Kabbalah. So you see right here, this is Tiferet. You know, Tifer or Ta-fa-a-ra-ta. You understand? But really, Tafara. You understand? Tafa-ara. You understand? Tafa-ara. You understand? Tiferet, they say today. But that is Tafari in the Hebrew on the tree. You understand, on the tree of life. So they want to spook you out about this so you don't even look at this while they still try to figure it out for themselves. You understand, they figured it out for themselves and they keep you outside the loop. So, you know, there's much more on this right here that we can go through and, you know, a lot of pictures on this and different interpretations and, you know, of course, we're not pictured there because most of us don't. Now, this is a chart right here that we'll go to show you the, what they call Phoenician alphabet. It's not really Phoenician. They want to give the credit to Phoenician. It's not really Phoenician. You understand? It's ancient Afro-Shemitic. The Phoenicians learned this from the Afro-Shemites. But even if you say, okay, Phoenician, they were black people originally. You understand? So you can see right here, test. And they said unknown. Notice what they say. Everything else has a meaning, but they say that this is unknown. They say unknown. What's the cross? We just showed you what it is. So you see how they confuse you. So if they don't know this, then how do they say it's Phoenician? You know, you have to ask yourself that question right there. How do you say it's Phoenician? Now, this is all interpretive. You understand? You have to remember that there's a is a big key in interpreting it. So we just kind of curious. Let's just put Egypt right there, Egyptian for a moment. We want to see what will show up. You know what I'm saying? What will show up in this, in the pictures right here. You know what I'm saying? Oh, some crazy stuff. Some real blatant crazy stuff is showing up right here. You know what I'm saying? Okay, there's some Egyptian stuff. You can see X right there. See how they mix it around. Some of the same pages, basically, as before. Oh, that's Obama right there. Hey, let's get Obama and Granny. You know what I'm saying? Or his mom, or his grandmother, I think so, yeah. Right? All right. Anyway, it's not about Obama, so, you know. So, yeah, Hulda, official Hulda company, right? But, and then, what's this in the heavens, you know, this is Medusa, Ra-Ra, Re-Re, you know, their interpretation of the heavenly signs, because they didn't, oh, this is a good one right here. Remember the woman we was talking about right here? You know, the woman right there, enthroned, listening to Mardium, the child, some say Isis, Horus. All this goes back to our ancient culture, but we have fallen asleep. You know what I'm saying? We're in a deep, most of our people are in a deep sleep. You know what I'm saying? In a very deep sleep. All right. We've gone a little bit off on this right here, but I hope that it's informative. And there's more to it. You can see that the pictures just almost go on forever. You understand? I mean, not really forever, but there's a lot of stuff right here. You understand? There's a lot of stuff right there. You know, the Cairo, you understand, the Cairo right there, or, you know, the Kur in Cristo, you know, but they want to spook you out. They want to say, yeah. Okay, let's see, yeah. Oh, we're missing some over here. We're missing some of it over here so we can see it more. So we might have missed a couple of photos and everything in this. All right, so that's the cross, the X, some of the mystery of the cross right there. You know what I'm saying? It all depends on who you have faith in, you know what I'm saying, or whether you trust, but verify this, you know what I'm saying, whether you trust, okay, that's a redirect notice, because some things they don't want you to check out. Some things are private that still pop up, you know what I'm saying, some things they don't want you to check out right here. So you see all the Western. So a lot of this, what we're seeing is Western speculation. You really need the skull and the crossbones. Where's that right here? We saw a photo right here that we wanted. Okay, here's what we just so ones and ones would recognize. Like this is some of the great page right here with the calendar. That's in the Hebrew, so we can know what time is it. You know, then we have this one here, which is similar to the Ethiopic, right? And the 231 gates, or 7x33. Anyway, let's back this up to where we were. Give thanks for that right there. But so we just wanted to prove to you this Tav, right, this cross, what the cross really, you know, means. You understand? In the biblical, especially this particular cross, when we talk about the Hebrew H8420, right? You see that very clearly? It's a mark. It's a sign of exemption, right? It's a mark, a sign of exemption. Exemption from what? Exemption from judgment. You understand? Exemption from judgment. And here's the three verses right here. It says Job 31 and 35. We didn't read that. It says, oh, that one would hear me. Oh, that one would really shema, really hear, behold, look and see, my desire, right? My desire, the same word for desire is my cross, you know, my mark, is that the Almighty would answer me, and that mine adversary had written a book. That my, it's talking about the Oro, Oyogo Munde, had written a book. You know what I'm saying? Look up the mystery of that. Check out Lennon Honor Films. You know what I'm saying? And support that brother in his critical thinking. You know what I'm saying? About a lot of these matters right here. So we see clearly from these two verses in Ezekiel, all right, that this mark right here,
according to 8420. Don't confuse that with other marks, because you have to know what Hebrew word are they referring to. You understand what Hebrew word is saying that this mark is upon the forehead of the men, right? This mark, and these men, you understand, are exempt from this judgment that is coming. You understand, those who have the true Christ, you understand, the true mark of the true Christ of Yeshua, HaMashiach, our Black Lord and Savior, in their frontal lobe, in their mind. You over? So when folks talk about what the cross means, you have to ask them, did you study any of this? You know, because what they might be talking about is this here or this here, and these are all other words that refer to a mark. So, where were we? We were talking about the Ashanti. Actually, we had left off on the Ashanti, because we wanted to define this whole matter about the Ashanti. But I think what we'll do right here is do this in, like, you know, a little micro, you know what I'm saying? You know, a little micro spiritual nukes right here. So this would be one, basically, speaking about the scepter and also speaking about the cross, right? And then we'll pick it up here on the Ashanti when we come forward, all right? So stay tuned. Shalom, Ras Tafari.